It's that time of year again when fashion presents all the great designs that help us look our best. I've saved a seat for you right here on the front row of the lines so you can see what great looks are going to be fantastic coming up this season. I'm Daniel M. This is Front Row. Hey guys, welcome to Front Row. I'm Daniel M, and I'm very excited that we're going to be here in the studio today. And I'm going to be talking to a really good friend of mine who has an amazing background in retail and fashion. We end up at a lot of events together. We have a great time together. Please welcome my guest, Barbara Cohen Bertoncini.
Hi, Daniel.
Hi, Barbara. It's
Thank
so great to see you.
It's such a pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
And this is the first time we've actually gotten to work together outside of
events. Exactly.
And we have so much fun when we're at events.
We do. We definitely do.
Now, you have a great history with retail. You've been in retail for over 20 years, which you started when you were two, obviously.
Thank you.
And you've worked with a lot of big designers and stuff like that.
Yes, I did.
You've had fun with it, haven't you?
I did, because when something's a passion of yours, it just comes very naturally and freely, and it didn't feel like work to me working in the fashion industry. I went to FIT, I graduated in the fashion buying and merchandising, marketing and advertising areas, and I had a ball with it, many events, many fashion shows. I started up many businesses throughout my career, and I'm just happy to be here today to go over some things with you.
Well, I'm always thrilled when I see you. And we end up at a lot of events together.
Yes.
And we always do make a bit of a stir because we're always dressed. I mean, you're dressed beautifully today.
Well, thank you. I heard you were wearing navy, so.
Yeah. Well,
I pulled out the navy.
Wearing navy. And for breast cancer awareness, I decided that I would do pink my own way.
I see that. That's very,
which,
very nice.
It was a wonderful weekend for that, what I noticed in the news. And,
yes.
And I got to participate in several different events.
October was the whole month.
But yesterday was wonderful. There were all these walks. There's this wonderful walk at Jones Beach that everyone is at, and it's amazing, like all of the supporters that come out there, and I'm so proud to see that, and so happy to wear a pink in my support. But we're going to talk a lot about fashion today.
Great, I love it.
We've both had an opportunity to see a lot of the stuff the designers have presented this year.
Yes.
Some of it just really brilliant, some of it not so much, right?
Exactly.
And we're going to do a little thing that we like to do when we're together is do this little he said,
she said,
and talk about the stuff and figure out what we like and what we're not really that thrilled with. So,
got it.
So let's get to it a little bit. You guys are going to be able to see it at home, but we've got a couple little things here, and let's start out with, for Carolina Herrera, these dresses. Now, you guys are going to get to see them. They're, she's so wonderful, but this just didn't do it for me at all.
It didn't do it for me either.
You didn't like it either.
Not really. It's not... It's not bad. It's not good. I mean, it's objective opinion. I'm not a flower person, and I don't see a lot of style in this. I don't know.
Neither do I. It's just plain. Even the runway set was just kind of boring. It wasn't very exciting to watch. But next
exactly.
up was Tory Burch. Now, Tory Burch gets so much play. Everywhere I look, all I see is the Tory Burch emblem on shoes, on bags, on everywhere. I kind of liked this. How do you feel about it?
The more I look at it, the more I was a little on the fence. It's a little very quiet and understated. Maybe a little boxy, some patterns. It doesn't have a great silhouette. But I do like the earthy tones, and it has a very organic feel to it. So, and I'm a Tory Burch fan. A lot of things I happen to like from her. And I kind of like this. I'm not crazy about it, but I like it.
You know, I agree. It's not exactly form-fitting, not flattering to a woman, but
not
perhaps
really.
A woman without the best of curves. It's a beautiful, the color is simple, understated.
Right.
I would imagine with a nice necklace or with an awesome pair of shoes, which we're
the
both
shoe,
fans of,
yes,
makes a
that's
big difference.
Me. I'm the shoe girl.
So we're both on this one. Carolina,
yes.
I'm
sorry. It's a little bit of a thumbs down.
It's a little too much gardening for me.
Yeah.
Which brings us to our next looks. And this was a big surprise for me.
Big surprise.
Chanel.
Big surprise.
What do you think?
You know, I am a big fan of Chanel. I like her designs, but one of them looks like she had confetti thrown at her. And I don't get the leggings there.
It's like a clown exploded on her, doesn't it? It's just
really
bad.
And I'm afraid of clowns,
yeah.
So that's a double whammy. And the other one looks like she's going to take off. She's a snowbird. She's going to take off for the winter to Florida.
That one was, all I could say is that if I were out to dinner and that were my companion, I would find an exit really fast.
Real fast.
I mean, I feel Elmer Fudd would come in and start shooting at any moment. It's no bird of paradise for me.
No. I don't get that. I don't get it.
But then, you know, then we look at these nice, I don't even know what to call them, monk robes? I mean, and that's not from Chanel. It's another designer, but
I don't know.
They're just,
I don't know. There's no words for something like this. It's very, very volume, very big design. I mean, the yardage of fabric,
yes,
it must be exorbitantly high.
Maybe that was the plan. Let's consume as much merchandise as we can.
But
here,
it doesn't look good on a small body, and I don't believe it would look good on a big body either. It would make a bigger girl big.
And of course, you know, when I look down, the only thing I see is a flip flop, and everyone that's ever met me knows how I feel about flip flops.
You don't even want someone wearing flip flops if they're getting a pedicure.
Listen, I wear Gucci loafers to the beach. You'll never see flip flops. So, so when we move through these now, this black and white stripe.
Right.
I'm kind of mixed feeling on
this. A little Beetlejuice to me. I want to say it three times, but I'm afraid he's going to appear. Beetlejuice.
You know,
but I'm not crazy about that.
Yeah, it's you know, I like the bottom and I like the cinch waist, but then all that stuff just going around doesn't do it for me.
Maybe if they didn't do it on the sleeve also, it's just too much.
Yeah, it is a bit much. Yeah. And she looks a little angry to have had to have worn it.
I would be angry too wearing that.
Yeah. So now this, I don't even, what color is this? Is this burgundy? Is it plum?
It looks like an eggplant, a dark burgundy.
How do you feel about this?
You know, maybe it's the angle we're looking at it. I like the slit. It looks like it has a nice feel when you're walking with it, the gown, the very nice and simple neckline. I don't know. I think I could go with this.
I have to tell you, I love it.
Yeah.
I find it to be like romantic and whimsical.
Yes.
And
whimsical.
And just
that's the word.
So feminine. I think any woman that walked in the room in something like that, unless she slipped and fell, I think my mouth would be a gap. Just looking at it. I love it.
It needed that slit to give it a little bit of sexy because it could have been a little bit matronly, but that slit gave it that little bit of
it's awesome. She almost
sexiness.
Looks like she just wants to walk off and take that home with her, and I would too.
It's gorgeous.
It's gorgeous. And unless I miss my guess, that's Dolce & Gabbana. Mm-hmm. So now coming into this little gray, what I call the office wear.
Right.
I love this. It doesn't flatter her that much, but I think in a business or a meeting, it's simple, it's elegant, it's classy. I kind of love it. It's very simple. The color is great. I just love it, and you're going to be shocked to know whose it is. But tell me what your thoughts are.
Yeah, I can't make out the designer, and I usually can. You know, it's a great color, gray for the office. The boat neck, three-quarter sleeve, it's not showing too much skin for the office. It's great. I think it's a little ill-fitting, but other than that, she looks okay. She looks good. It's a good length. It could be a little longer for work. And I'm a little shocked that you like this dress because you're not a fan of flats.
You know, I didn't really notice them. I liked the dress so much, I didn't even notice
her shoes. I think
maybe
she had a little bit of a kitten heel with that, and it had a little bit longer length to make up for the heel. That makes it a little shorter.
I agree.
I would love it.
I agree.
Would love it.
The interesting thing about this, we're talking about all these designers, and the interesting thing about this is Banana Republic.
Is it?
How stunning is that for
Look
Banana
at
Republic?
That.
I'm really shocked. Bravo, Banana Republic.
Very good.
So let's move on to red. Red's a great color, fiery, very feminine.
A big accent color this season.
Oh.
Shoe, bag.
I'm looking at all of this, and, you know, the sort of sweater dress thing is just so pretty.
Yes,
I love that.
Yes, it is.
You like that, too. That's great. I'm a real fan of the red dress. I'm not really sure about the flower or
Which
hat
one?
That's on there
the one
on her head.
Yeah, I'm not
it's
too
not,
crazy about that
it's
one.
Not a fun look. I don't think that's flattering, but the dress is nice.
I mean, it looks a little severe. I don't know. It looks like it has shoulder pads. It's very, It's severe looking to me, the dress. I don't know if it's welcoming when you come into a party or a ball with something like that. I think I would just stand at attention and salute her.
That's funny. And I found it to be a little glamorous, but I think you might be. I might have to change my mind on go with you.
No, you're a he say and I'm a she say kind of girl.
I love the boots on the last red dress,
yes.
Which it's very deep, you know, not quite red.
Very plungy.
I love the boot. The neckline, I'm not loving.
Very plunging.
It's just, I just don't like it. I think that it's just too much.
It's very low.
Yeah.
It is very low cut. Maybe there is a place for that. You know, maybe there is a place to go with something like that. Or really, you know, club,
I do like the boots.
Clubbing.
And I
the
do like...
The boots look great.
I like the slit.
I don't know if the boots go with that dress, though. The dress is a little bit silky and... plunging. I would have thought a strappy sandal, but they went with a suede boot, which looks a little heavy for this outfit.
Right.
But other than that,
I kind of like it. But
I think if she showed a little bit more leg and had a strappy shoe, this could have been pulled off more as a sexy look.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to agree with you there.
Okay.
So let's go to casual. So we've got three looks here for casual.
Okay.
And I think I've actually even seen you in one of these looks.
I think I have all of these. Except the Sex in the City look there.
I kind of like them. I'm not a big fan of the ripped jean, but I like the shoe with the jean and the bag. And
yeah, she's pulling that off, a little Chanel-y type sweater. Skinny jean with the tears in it is always a look, with a nice matching shoe and bag. That's not bad. That's a great little outfit.
I think
outfit.
It's a nice look. I
yeah.
love the red pants with the jean shirt.
Me
our next
too.
Look.
Love jean shirts.
I love the boots. You know, tucked into that boot, it would be awesome. I know it's very popular, but I've never been a fan of any kind of animal print. It just doesn't do it for me.
Either you love it or you hate it. There are people like there is no shades of gray, but either you love animal print or you don't. But I think that when you combine animal print with red,
right.
it has a little bit of a look. And if you just add a little touch of animal print, it can work an outfit
it is
to
a
the benefit of the outfit.
It is a small
but
amount.
But don't overdo animal print because we don't want to go to the zoo when we are visiting somebody.
Yeah.
Don't overdo the animal print with the shoe and the bag and the scarf and the sweater.
It's
a little too much.
It's more of a menagerie than anything else.
Less is more.
I agree.
Less is more.
We've got a nice black and white here of a man and woman. I love the guy's look with the pea coat.
That's your look.
I like
you
it with
that.
The turned up little thin jean and a nice shoe.
Yeah.
I'm just appalled by the woman's outfit.
I don't get it.
I don't. It's just, I'm not sure what the pants are doing.
I didn't even know it was pants. It looks like maybe a skirt or.
It's just.
A long skirt. It is pants.
Sometimes I wonder what the intent is. You know, it's not romantic, it's not pretty, it's not flattering, it's not sporty, it's just not, it's a big fail for me.
It is. I mean, the pants just don't even make her look like a woman, the low crotch, it's just, I don't get the look at all.
He might have looked better in those pants.
Yeah.
But if they had switched the bottoms, it would have been perfect.
Yes.
So let's go on to one of your favorite topics, and certainly mine, and
love
this, the first
shoes.
Picture is actually someone sent me, and it's from the Museum of Shoes. Now, who knew that there was an exhibit of a museum of
yes,
shoes,
there was.
And
yes,
I
there was.
I saw this immediately and said, "Wow, this is really awesome." A bit much.
Are we talking about this?
The red sole with the steel heel is just
yeah,
amazing.
Looks like Louboutin, but
yep.
we don't know what it is.
I'm not sure. It might be, but
it looks like something I would totally wear.
And that is one shoe designer, along with Manolo, that women just melt over.
Yeah.
And what is it? What is the allure?
It's just such a... first of all, the shoe is produced by man. You know, it's just knowing that you have this shoe. It's like a piece of artwork. It's been put together meticulously by very skilled hands. The red sole just gives it a... Like, you've already made it to this designer by just seeing the sole
right.
alone. That you're lucky enough to wear this, like you could put artwork up on your wall
right.
from a major artist. This is a major designer. I have a Louboutin shoe. It's sexy. It's a gorgeous Mary Jane. Very high. Very, obviously, it's not, it's probably just a runway kind of a shoe.
Right.
You don't wear this really on an everyday basis.
Well, I picked that for you, I have to say that I personally...
It's kind of like the heels I'm wearing.
Yeah, well, you're wearing awesome shoes, as always. I picked it for you. I knew that you would like it. I'm not a big fan of the metal and the... But well, I have to say that when I see that red sole, you know, my eye perks up just a little bit.
Right.
And then, Manolo, we've got, you know, this beautiful blue shoe and a beautiful, simple black shoe.
That's the classics.
I think that they're gorgeous. Yes. I think that they're truly gorgeous.
They are gorgeous, and they feel delicious when you have a Manolo on your foot.
Yeah.
There's just something about a designer shoe. It just fits your foot beautifully. Sometimes people wonder how you could wear that kind of shoe all day, but if it's a good, well-made designer shoe with the leather insole, yeah, the leather bottom, you can go a whole day with it.
And we've talked about this before, you know, at many things. Mm-hmm. You know what? Comfort is overrated. Nobody's ever said, wow, they look so sexy and comfortable. So we're just going to quickly just jump to guys.
Okay.
You know, we've got a really nice looks on guys. I love the tuxedo with the jean. Do you agree?
Love.
Okay, it's a great look for men.
Great look.
Not a fan of the suit and vest with the contrasting pant.
I was never a big vest person for a guy.
I mean, they're very popular on men now. I think it's good, but I would want to have a contrasting vest than a suit.
Really, he didn't need the vest.
And I love the singular color. I do this a lot.
That monochromatic look. Yeah. It makes somebody always look taller, thinner, put together. The cliff in the chin doesn't hurt either.
Hurts.
I mean, this is a win-win.
I may have to bang into my chin with a hammer when I get home, but I love this. I do this a lot. I do it with blue, with a dark blue shirt and a Burberry tie. I love this look. I think it always gets attention.
Gorgeous.
Gorgeous. Overall, we seem to agree on many of the things, except for some of the faux pas that the designers have made.
I'm shocked. We really did. We really... We are on the same page.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised, you know, I mean, because you always, I mean, who are you wearing today?
Well, this dress is Valentino red.
Okay.
And the shoe is navy also, Cassidy, from my favorite shoe store in Great Neck, Stephen Dan. And he sells Valentino as well.
Right.
But that's it, Valentino red and Cassidy.
Well, you look awesome as
thank
always.
You.
I always
thank
love
you. And so do
seeing
you.
Why, thank you.
Mr. Navy in pink.
I always love seeing you at events.
Thank
I love
you.
When we get to
same
socialize.
Here.
And
same
I want to
here.
Thank you so much
it was
for
such a
coming
pleasure.
In today.
It's such
it was
a
really
pleasure.
Great. And we're going to do this again, you promise?
Promise.
Okay, we'll look
got
at
it.
All the fashions that are coming in. So you guys got a little tip on what's happening in the fashion world. You got a little bit of a runway show. You got to see what we got to see in the seats at the foot of the runway this season, and it's been a great time for us, and I can't wait to do it again. You guys are viewing today. I want to thank my guest Barbara for joining us. I'm really excited to have you guys at our next show, where we're going to be looking at a lot of great things, including the men's mobile van, which is awesome. For Front Row, I'm Daniel M. Remember, life's too short to view from a distance.